Okay, you can spin it now. It's good.
Hello.
That's good.
Yeah, it's still looking great, mate.
What a glorious day.
Welcome back to St Ives. This is the next chapter in going around the UK with a very small boat. In this episode, we're going up the North Cornish coast towards the Bristol Channel and hopefully stopping in at a little island called Lundy.
Very excited.
We're running late. High tide is long gone and we're now driving on the sand. Chris is worried he's going to get stuck.
I'm new to this, so if
we're making it in. We're sinking in.
Right. We still might not get away.
No.
Joining me on this leg is Sam. He's an electronics engineer. Used to be in a band with Charlie, and he plays double bass.
Right, Harry, tell me what to do.
Thank you.
Here we go.
Okay, Sam. You keep holding the rope.
Slightly misty morning, but I'm hoping this mist is going to lift and it's going to be a glorious day. Possibly a bit of rain. We're heading east along the North Cornish coast. Hopefully we can do about 40 miles to Port Isaac. Right, chart, we're going to be on. Just passing Gudrevi Island. It's a sort of headland and there was a little bit of a choppy bit back there where it was kind of a bit hairy, wasn't it, Sam? It's kind of exciting.
It was quite good.
Big swell. But we come around the other side and it's fine around here.
You surfed it very well.
We did a bit of surfing. Bigger waves on this side of Cornwall, I think, on the north coast. We're looking at maybe 1.5 metre waves today as opposed to 0.5, which we're used to. Well, a bit of surfing now.
Lovely.
It seems to be getting calmer as we head this way.
It's definitely more choppy than I was promised.
Yes, I said it was going to be really flat today. Yeah. Oh yeah. Around here basically it looks like Jurassic Park. What's your favourite bit in Jurassic Park?
My favourite bit? Flying in at the beginning, actually. The look of the island. It's got a Nordic edge to it, I felt, a minute ago, when the weather was a lot worse.
It's nice, actually, cruising like this. But it's going to take a lot longer. We've got loads of time, though.
Waves are getting a bit smaller, and we're just passing St Agnes. Coming up is Newquay, where the surf dudes go. It's very wild out here. It just feels like it's full of big cliffs with the occasional little bay. We're eating the miles now, Sam, aren't we?
We are eating. Oh, I don't talk about food, though.
Sun's coming out.
Everything feels better when the sun comes out, doesn't it?
It does. The swell is chipping away at me. Still a bit sick.
You feeling a bit sick?
Yeah,
no, you're not. Are you really?
Sleepy and a bit sicky.
Well, do you want to get a bit of a speed on to get rid of the seasickness? That's what they say, isn't it?
I
Are you regretting coming on this trip, Sam? This is the hard bit. You've got to get past it.
I know, Harry. You're sick.
Oh, I'm sorry, Sam. What about something to eat? Do you have a snack? You don't want a snack.
I don't think so, you know. I think I'm just enjoying the ride. Mm. I'm actually feeling very sleepy.
Oh, no.
I had my eyes closed a couple of times then driving along.
Right, we've been banging along for quite a long time, thinking, are we having a good time? Not sure. But we're just pulling into Newquay now, and on the headland over here is a very famous hotel, the Headland Hotel. It was made famous, well, not really, but it was the hotel they used in that classic spooky film, The Witches. It's spooky, isn't it?
Spooky film. It is spooky when you're little.
Do you get really scared by the witches?
I get scared just looking at that hotel, Harry.
Yeah.
Oh, it was a great film.
Roald Dahl. It had Rowan Atkinson as the waiter.
Did.
Damn.
I can't make it, Harry. You're gonna have to leave me. Just give me 5 minutes sleep.
Don't you think looking at the horizon is gonna be better for you?
What, than sleeping?
Hmm.
No.
It won't be like this all the time, okay?
I know, wait.
When it's really flat, you can whiz along and it's more like driving a car. Do you regretting that you came, Sam?
No, I'm not.
You are not.
Not for a second, Harry.
Stay in there, Sam.
Not for a second, I'm having a lovely time.
And we could go into Newquay Harbour. And if you want, you can get on dry land. Would that be good?
Yeah, that sounds good. Something quite high, isn't it?
Newquay is a popular tourist destination. I think often it's a lot sunnier than it is right now. But that's not stopping those holidaymakers from getting out on the boards, because this beach has no shortage of people in canoes and other watercraft.
Lots of wetsuits, motorboats, power boarders, jet skiers, paddle boarders.
Exactly.
Snooker queues.
So in Newquay there's a very strange house on a rock, which you can see just up there. It's called the Island, and it's connected by its own private suspension bridge. Apparently, it's the only privately owned suspension bridge in the UK, or maybe the world. I think it was recently for sale, and maybe now you can rent it as a holiday cottage. It would be a strange place to live.
You feeling a bit better now?
Yeah.
We got a plan.
I think I got a bit of colour back in my hood.
We'd hope for good weather, but tomorrow it definitely is good weather, and maybe even by this evening when we're settling down.
It's just behind the clouds, Harry. Breaking through.
Got about another 10 miles. It looks like it's getting a bit misty over there, Sam.
That's where we're going, over there into the mist. To Port Isaac. How do you feel?
Ready.
We're right, we'll just take it slow, we'll be fine.
I think fast is better, actually.
Really?
We're fine. Look, we've got our high-vis jackets on. Yeah, I feel much better, actually.
Okay, good. Thanks. Maybe it's time for a Scotch egg.
No.
What about some a berry medley?
Mm-hmm.
Like a strawberry.
Mm.
Yeah. What about a grape?
Oof. No, oh dear. Like a shuckling pig. Thank you.
Mm. All right. Good.
I'll give it a go.
Onward.
Mm. Very nice.
Is this what you thought it was going to be like?
It's all right though, isn't it? It's cozy. You've got your berry medley there.
The berry mix.
I think actually I feel pretty good. The waves definitely seem to have calmed down a bit. Sam?
I was. When we go past, Harry.
You see what lighthouse that is?
That's Trevose Head up there. We are passing the Camel Estuary. Up there you've got Padstow.
Good driving, Sam. How's the seasickness now?
Oh, I tell you, as soon as we stop,
really?
It comes back, but as we're flying, I'm just happy. I'm a happy man.
Scotch egg?
No.
No, but you were thinking about
it. I did think about it, but no, not yet.
We've made it to Port Quin, which is a little inlet where we're going to be spending the night probably. I think we're still in Cornwall.
We are.
Up here is a really cool little castle called Doyden Castle, and it's absolutely tiny. I've always wanted to stay there. Looks like there's people staying there now. There's a car park there. But it's a very tiny little castle.
Look at this. This is nice.
If you anchor there, you'd be all right.
It's going to make it quite shallow quite soon.
So we could anchor here.
14 foot, that's the deeper bit where we just were. So we can do a nice little weather check.
Yeah.
We're up.
Are we going to get off it?
What are we on, the front?
We're on a rock at the back.
Oh yeah, you can see it down there. That was a bit sudden. But, I mean, we were all over the rocks, actually.
I did think, oh, getting a bit complacent here, just sitting and drifting.
Just joking and chatting. Like, let's go.
So maybe it was the skeg that hit the rock. It was like a flat rock.
This is very helpful. It's kind of like the swimming kind of parking service. So do you live here?
Yeah, I live just up the road in near Polder.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah, I come down there a lot. Yeah, that's Screamers.
Which one?
This is Screamers in here.
Oh, is it?
About 200 years ago, there was a boat that crashed in... right in the bay there.
Oh, and, really?
You could hear the screams from right up in the village, up at the top.
Jeez. So you think camping-wise, if we walk along up here somewhere, we'll probably be able to...
Yeah, you'd be fine. There's like a tunnel of trees along this bit here. It's sheltered. Yeah, up there should be right.
Thank you very much.
Some good local advice.
Yeah, it's very good from the parking services.
So, the anchor's like over there. It feels pretty good. Well, we've got a treat here. We splashed out on a new dinghy. Look, this is a good boat, right?
Wow. So what size did you go for, Harry?
It's bigger than I thought it was.
You think that'll get all the stuff in?
Let's go ashore.
It's a fully laden dinghy there, Sam.
Bags of room for you, my friend.
Hey,
you're off the boat
to get off it. I'm sitting in my head. I had a lovely time.
Yeah. There's more to come, Sam.
No,
do not worry.
I'm just finding my sea legs. I had to gauge myself because obviously I'm a dyed-in-the-wool land lover.
Take me to the campsite, Sam.
Oh, I'm getting drippity drips.
Dry land.
We found the perfect camping spot.
Goodwin's just anchored just down there. We're just going to be nestled in here. This is perfect, Sam. I mean, even if it does get windy, we're protected on both sides. What a camping spot, Sam.
Beautiful spot. It's a really stunning spot.
3, 2, 1, get up!
Refried beans and a loomy. That really looks delicious.
This is what I've been waiting for all day. Delicious. I'll save you that bit, Harry, as you're the skipper.
We're like men living on a cliff.
Like men of the woods, aren't we?
We are.
After a hard day on the water.
It's going to be comfy. Anyway. Right, I'm getting in the tent.
Yeah, I'm getting in.
Bedtime.
Night, Harry.
Tomorrow we head to Lundy, Sam.
Right. Yeah, we do.
I think you should take some nice shots of me just falling asleep. Just to show you how tired I am. I know. I tell a lie about being flat. I'm sloping towards the middle as well. Good night, Harry.
God, are you in the flat bit?
No, I'm not. I'm against the wall. The zip seems to be on the other side.
The lapping of the waves.
Is that what that is?
How did you sleep, Sam?
Oh, delight. Fleshy back by my side all night.
Oh, sorry, I was sliding down the hill a bit.
I didn't know where I was, but...
Did you start trying to push me uphill at one point?
Somehow you've put yourself on the flat bit.
I am. Well, tonight you can have this side.
Can I? Well, tonight, Sam, we will be sleeping on Lundy Island.
What's the weather like? Blue sky. Let's get out on the water, Sam.
We're off.
I think his coffee's ready, Sam.
Did you bring the cream?
No, there's no milk.
What?
So, we've got oats. So simple. But the key is...
You've got porridge on your beard. On your moustache.
No, the twits. Key is to not stop mixing, Harry.
Not stop stirring.
Now, a true good bowl of porridge has a little pinch of salt in there, but I think being by the sea, that's doing it for us. Look at that, guys.
Come get it. Oh, cheers, Sam.
That's lovely.
Get it dry.
Lundy Island, famous for puffins. Look at this. Sun's coming out compared to yesterday. It's burning off. Look at haze.
Let's go for a morning
Let's
dip.
Let's go for a morning dip and then get on the boat.
Let's do it. That.
Boat's still there.
Ready to go.
Trust in Goodwin.
Port Quin almost feels like it's not changed in a very long time. Most of the cottages are run by the National Trust. And it's very quiet, and feels like a slice of the olden days. Onward to Lundy.
I back, don't you? Not like how many people. So, time check,
just get
it's 9:30,
so we're going to be 10:30, 11:30, 12:30, 1:30, which is great.
Get a tan today, Harry.
It's true, actually. Sun cream tan.
Oh, I love it.
Oh, yeah.
Tintagel! Arthur! King Arthur. That's your game. The legend of Tintagel.
We've made it to Tintagel, made famous by the Arthurian legend. King Arthur was said to have been born in this castle, or conceived in this castle, I think, looking on Wikipedia. Now, I originally thought King Arthur was a real person, but apparently it's widely regarded now that King Arthur was completely made up. In the 10th century, a historian wrote about King
there
Arthur.
Currently no gale warnings.
No gale warnings. Yes, Lundy, no gale warnings. I originally thought that King Arthur was real, I think, growing up, and it turns out he's completely fictional, probably. But a 10th century historian wrote a history book all about King Arthur. He was a brave king, winning loads of battles, and I think it's widely regarded now the guy just lied and made it all up. And then loads of people have added to it over the years. So I think the sword in the stone and all of that kind of stuff, which when you think about it, is unlikely to be real. All of that kind of stuff was added hundreds of years afterwards. In the legend, he was conceived in this castle. Obviously, what is real is the castle. This is a real castle on this cool island. So the castle's completely ruined, but the remains are there. This is probably where the Knights of the Round Table hung out. And there might be some truth in some of it, that's the thing. But you can see, if you were making it up, this would be a good place to put your fictional legendary king. The legend of King Arthur. Steeped in magical history. There we go. Or legend. Maybe it is real, that's the thing. So, I mean, the sword and the stone, it's unlikely. The lady in the lake?
The hairy hands.
The what?
Legend of King Arthur and the Round Knight's Table. Knights of the Round Table. King Arthur.
So did you bring your own hat?
This is my sun hat. Spirit donkey sun hat. That you were looking for, mate. Well, that wet fish yesterday.
Stop. We just stopped here at Duckpool Beach. It's a very small little public beach, and right next to it is a great radar base. It's called GCHQ Bude, which is the government listening service, a sort of semi-secret listening base. It's basically an eavesdropping service to listen to the data being sent between different countries. So you can see the domes up there and absolutely massive satellite dishes. It's a secret base, but not very secret really. GCHQ stands for the Government Communication Headquarters, and that is their secret listening service for picking up international data and eavesdropping on the world. Island, which is just about 10 miles offshore. So over there we can see in the mist the silhouette of Lundy Island. Right, nearly at Lundy, so I'm just going to do a quick fuel tank swap over.
Oh, there's a bit more in this one.
Right there.
Island, Sam. You sick?
No, I'm good.
You good?
Hello, Mr. Seal.
Hello.
It's the Lundy Seal.
We made it to Lundy.
Here we are.
It's beautiful, isn't it? So this is where we're going to anchor.
Absolutely beautiful day.
Oh, that's a good carrot.
You grew that.
I grew that.
Try it.
I grew that, I ate it.
Okay. Oh.
Perfect shot.
Oh,
your friend.
Oh, Goodwin!
Crabs and crops.
If you just follow the road up, it'll take you to the village.
There's a lot of mad history on the island.
How's that?
Pirates to also.
Really?
So, yeah.
We just met some of the people working on the island who are very kindly going to give us a lift in their Land Rover with all of our stuff up to the campsite. But before we do, they're just using the GoPro to film some of the spider crabs that are down on the seabed. There are a lot of them and they're very spidery and crabby.
the people working here very kindly giving us a lift in this extreme machine.
You're becoming the Goodwin support team.
Is that it?
Yeah. Goodwin's the name of the boat.
Oh, right.
God, it's like we're on a bloody Mediterranean holiday.
That's Newquay House.
Right. So that's the kind of big manor house?
That's the manor house, yeah. So that was built in the 1850, 1860.
Right.
Hey, we're getting parked to the door. Who's putting the tents up? Yeah. Thank you very, very much. This is incredible service.
Look at that, Sam. What service?
Who's going to put the tent up, Harry?
Look at that view.
Thank you.
Say goodbye.
Goodbye. Those guys are very nice. They just gave us a lift with all our stuff. Now we've got to put the tent up.
Terrible way to look at it.
Might be slightly flat a bit. Maybe it's slightly flatter there.
Hello. We've got neighbours. You can keep the noise down. Is that your generator on there? Watch the TV.
So, yep, northerly. I'll meet you in the tavern.
All right, see you down there.
Yeah, man.
Lundy Island is a very small block of granite sitting about 10 miles off the coast of North Devon. It's about 2 miles long and half a mile wide. The only people who live here all the time are the 25 people who work here to run the island and keep it going. The island's dotted with little interesting old lighthouses and buildings from its previous life, and these are now rented out to fund the island to keep it going.
Right, this is where we can find out about Lundy. So here, this is Lundy, isn't it? Fog's coming in.
The fog has come down in Lundy.
I mean, God, it's really changed now.
Oh, we can get lost out here, mate. I'm scared, Harry. There's definitely a beast out here. 10 minutes ago, it was a lovely day, and now it's very foggy and a bit colder. There's been a lot of shipwrecks on Lundy. You can see why, because it gets very foggy. We're out in the middle of the sea.
There's a lot of shipwrecks around this coast. And so they then built the two north and south lighthouse stations, which lighthouse keepers were very fond of being posted out here, because it's one of the few lighthouse stations that has a pub.
We
need to get to the Mariscus Tavern.
Let's go to the pub. Come on, Sam.
Who'd have thought it? I thought we were wild camping.
I'll have a bit of pepper. Salt.
Although it isn't a sachet.
Good tartar sauce.
What's that, Sam? What's that?
God, no! God!
We're lost in the fog.
We are lost in the fog. We could be anywhere now.
Lundy Island's pretty small, it's only a couple of miles long, so we're just going for a quick stroll in the fog to see the old lighthouse.
Nothing but the rustle of a raffer jacket.
This is the old lighthouse. As you can see, as you can't see, it gets foggy here. It was built in 1816, and quite soon after that, they abandoned this one, and they built two more on the other side of the island, where it's not foggy as much. But it's probably quite often foggy.
Sam!
Please come on up.
I'm coming.
Thank you.
Jaya Jaya.
Hi, yeah.
Across a great sea. Many thought they would die, but they made it, and their tale is this one.
Hello. You're really tame. Oh, off you go.
Bubbling. Bubbling in a book.
Night, Sam.
Night, Harry.
What a day.
Oh, what a day. That I can't wait for tomorrow.
No.
Right, it's still foggy.
We slept in the middle of a cloud, but it's hopefully going to burn off, isn't it, Sam?
They say.
Mm.
It looks... Well, I mean, I don't know anything about weather, thankfully, because it doesn't look like it is.
Morning!
Hello.
Hello. This is the grass that you can't reach, isn't it, over here? Here we go. Well, it's been very nice to meet you. Thanks for having us. Yeah, we'll see you next time. Neighbours. Good to meet the neighbours. That is...
It's burning off.
Any minute now.
Lundy's really only just a few houses, but... It's got a very good shop. It's got its own fire engine. Lundy also has its own workshop to maintain all the vehicles.
So this is Rob. He's the manager on the island. Basically, Rob is the king of Lundy Island.
I look after the people and all the visitors that come and see us. It's such a special place, really. So everyone wants it to be looked after. Yeah. It is quite remote, even though we can see the land. Sometimes the weather makes sure that we have trouble getting some support. Yeah. 75% of the island is SSSI, Special Site of Scientific Interest, so we have to manage that. We've got listed buildings, special grassland areas. We've got wild deer, we've got wild sheep.
Good luck bird watching.
Thank you, Andy. You're going around, so where are you planning to go next?
We're going to go to Clovelly this afternoon.
Oh, Clovelly, lovely.
And then Ilfracombe in the evening.
Yeah.
It's a bit bumpy, I'm afraid.
No, that's fine.
Oldenburg, Lundy Rob. We're all ready for you down here. A few yachts in the bay here, and a few ribs. One of the yachts is quite close to the jetty.
Yeah, okay, we'll go myself.
There's Goodwin, Sam. She looks tiny, doesn't it? Our boat looks so small.
Yeah, tiny.
We really can't manage through the summer without our volunteers. They'd help with all of the repairs, cutting the grass, mending stone walls, fences, all the bird monitoring, seal monitoring. At the moment, we've got 26 people working on the island. It is a big, complex operation. We've got carpenter's workshop, maintenance workshop for vehicles, the generators, water treatment plant, All of these things are going to be looked after. We have supply ships, we've got to look after stores, cargo. There's the underbelly of removing rubbish, dealing with sewage. People take it for granted on the mainland, but everything that happens here has to be done by somebody.
What are the conditions like out there?
Foggy.
Is it?
Yeah, a bit foggy today.
What's the visibility like?
About a mile.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Yeah.
So we'll be able to see anything coming?
Yeah.
Coming the other way?
Yeah. Sea conditions are okay.
Okay, it's flat basically.
Yeah.
You'll see us with that very small rib over there.
Oh, the grey one?
Yeah.
Yeah, you'll be right, yeah. I think it's burning off.
Okay,
it's
great.
We've had a lovely time on Lundy. It's time to go. Let's go to Clovelly. It's 10 miles that way on the North Devon coast.
Right, get back on the boat. I'm swimming in.
Right, loading up for the next big voyage.
Ooh.
Apparently all the seals hang out down this end of the island. Wind's getting up a bit, but we're about to cruise to Clovelly. The steering's got a bit loose.
The steering wheel likely to come off.
It feels like the steering wheel's about to come off.
No, it's the column inside the steering thing.
Is it? Where's the toolkit? In the black one?
Oh, well, I think there's much we can do actually looking at that. So let's just leave it.
Made it to Clovelly. The tide's out, so we're going to have to scrabble up the rocks there. Clovelly's an old fishing village, and it's owned by the Lord of the Manor up on the hill, Mr. Rouse, and it's basically been unchanged for hundreds of years. Still has the same cobbled road, which they used to use donkeys to drag things up. We're going to pop in for a quick pub stop, and hopefully the support team will be meeting us with a bit of fuel.
There he is.
You see him?
He's on the beach.
Where is he?
There he is, holding two red cans.
Oh, here he is. He's stumbling over. Should we go and see him?
Let's go and get in there.
Hello. No, we're going to come in on the inflatable.
There's our man.
6.2 feet. All right.
God, look at this place. Suddenly got drunk.
Local petrol station services.
There was a little bit of petrol in there when I found it in the shed.
But oh, that'll be nice.
Hello, hello. Here we are. The usual suspects.
Saved the day again.
Tell me about this hub wall, historian man.
Well, I don't really know a lot. I know it's 14th century.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Big rock.
This harbour wall is obviously very old because these stones look like the Flintstones put them in.
They were bigger then, weren't they? Let's go.
And some chips.
There we go.
Support team, co-driver.
techno driver.
Right, maybe it's time to go, Sam.
Come on then, Harry.
It's the last bit, Sam.
It's true. I think I've actually improved.
You have. You've got the skills up.
I think I've found my sea leg.
We'll see you in Ilfracombe, Chris.
See you in Ilfracombe.
Right, back on that boat.
See you in Ilfracombe, Chris.
Very nice. Is that it?
Whoa! One last swim before.
Ooh. Beautiful, eh?
Beautiful, Sammy!
My wallet was in my pocket. It's got loads of money in it. Right. Ilfracombe?
Ilfracombe.
To Ilfracombe!
Either way!
To the River Torridge, where there's Biddeford and Barnstable. We're just coming in towards Croyde to look at an amazing house. It's not really a house. It's something I saw on an episode of Grand Designs, that classic TV show. It's completely crazy, and it's the work of a madman. It takes one to know one. Basically, this guy was hell-bent on building the biggest, most ridiculous house.
Look at it.
Is that it?
Yeah.
It's huge.
I think this building site's been like this for a few years now, and it's in one of the most preserved and picturesque headlands. How they got permission to build it, it's hard to believe. If you're a fan of Grand Designs, then you've probably seen the episode where the guy runs out of money trying to build an absolutely ridiculously massive house based on a lighthouse. Everybody warns him that it's going to run out of money, and sure enough, it does. And it's still now a building site. It's absolutely massive. It seems to have some new scaffolding up. I think it's been like that for a couple of years. And whether it's ever going to get finished, it's hard to see. Apparently, it's just cost millions already. But it's maybe testament to over-ambition. It's completely unfinished. It would probably cost another million to finish it. It doesn't look like there's any work going on up there, but then it's now the evening. Maybe it's still going. Who knows? Onward.
Normally. Onward, champ.
Evening run.
Here we go. Final push.
Just passing Woolacombe. Gets a little bit choppy around these headlands, doesn't it?
Yeah.
God. Whoa.
Hold on.
Nice driving, mate. Whoa! Woo!
It's spiky around the corner there.
Yeah, we're through the worst. That was it's getting very choppy around that headland. What headland was that? Mort Point, that was called.
Very nearly there, my boy.
Coming into our final destination, the town of Ilfracombe. A trip to Ilfracombe would not be complete without looking at this. This recent statue by the artist Damien Hirst. It's called Verity. It's of a pregnant woman, but it's sort of like an anatomical model where her skin's peeling open and you can see all her organs inside.
It's only been up for a few years. Damien Hirst moved nearby, and Ilfracombe's become a kind of arty place. It's quite gross, but interesting at the same time. That's the real deal. Can he actually see us?
I think you have much interest in it.
Oh, Sam, we made it. We've made it. We can see the support team on the slipway.
Oh, it's beautiful.
We nearly got hit by the lifeboat coming out. We made it to the slipway, but as we came in, everyone was shouting at us because we narrowly avoided being hit by the lifeboat being launched.
We made it, Harry.
No.
I was expecting to just be sunning myself on the back.
God, the beard's really coming on, Chris.
It is. It's getting there. We've
got to wait for the lifeboat and wait.
Yes, bit of action there. A couple of people have got cut off from the tide.
Oh, really? A cracking trip on the good ship Goodwin. The steering feels a bit loose, might have to look at that. And I was looking at the transom and wondering if the engine was going to fall off for a while. Sam's shivering, so the camera's jobbling up and down. That was a lovely run.
Boys, we were not the news.